København. Welcome to the second annual Face of Denmark competition. I am Christian Sebastian Lauritsen, and I am one of your hosts this evening.
And I am John Paul Hamilton. Tonight we will be meeting 15 of the most articulate, intelligent, beautiful, inside and outside, women from all over Denmark.
I aften er en helt fantastisk mulighed, både for Danmark og for de 15 fantastiske piger ude bagved.
Yes, we have people from all over the world watching tonight. From the Philippines, and they're also here apparently, the USA, Indonesia, Australia, South Africa, Brazil, Mexico, and more. Let's show them how loud we can be in Denmark, because we have a reputation here, not me, because I'm not Danish, but
no, not
in
you.
Denmark for being a little serious. But since I've been here, I can't really see that anymore. I think that once you knock down the wall, you get a really funny, funny group of people that are full of excitement and energy. And I've heard how loud you can be. I've been out. So let's be loud. When you see your favorite girl or any girl, just come out and cheer for them because they've worked really hard for this. And I know, I've been there, and so have you. Yeah. So, yep.
I skal alle sammen huske på, i aften der er showet til fordel for Støt Brysterne. Hver eneste pige ude bagved er blevet bedt om at medbringe en sponsorgave til en værdi af minimum 500 kroner, som vi har auktioneret væk. Det har simpelthen været en del af deres kriterier for at få lov til at stille op. Det er en af de ting, de har gjort i løbet af de sidste 2 måneder, De har arbejdet simpelthen så hårdt, I fatter det slet ikke. Det vil sige, som John også siger, når de kommer herud, så får Søren hæb på dem og skrig og vin og alt, hvad jeg overhovedet kan. Okay? Og nu er vi klar til at møde de 15 piger en af gangen, og de kommer her i deres Sherry Hill kjoler, der er blevet sponsoreret af Sherry Hill Fashion.
Alexandria Eissinger, Roskilde. Sofie, Nielsen, Christianshavn. Sara, Danielsen, Odense. Christiane Krøl, Lyngby. Christina Mikkelsen, København.
Hånd igen.
Well, what an opening.
Yeah, fantastic. Nu er vi nået til det tidspunkt på aftenen, hvor vi skal introducere en helt speciel person.
Yes. It is really great to see that so many current and former title holders are involved with the new Face of Denmark organization. I spot two former Miss Earths, the first one included, who came from Denmark. And I spot a first runner-up at Miss Universe over there. I mean, I can't see her, but I know she's over there. A finalist at Miss World, also over there. A Miss Scandinavia winner, right there, Gita. I'm talking about you. And a first runner-up at Miss International. And of course, one of the newest additions in the sisterhood, the reigning Miss Universe Denmark, Cecilia Vellenberg.
Yeah. Lad os få en herud, Cecilie Vellenberg.
We go hide away in daylight. We go undercover, wait up the sun. Got a secret side and play. radioen Danmark.
Now let's bring out the woman from the video, Cecilia Vellemba, the reigning Miss Universe Denmark. Hi, dear. It's been an exciting year since August. What has been your favorite part so far?
I think my favorite part is everything that, you know, all the culture you meet. It's really mean a lot to meet all these people. And all the nice backstage people, they are so awesome. We have so much fun, all the nice girls from the different countries. It just makes you feel like you've seen the world from a different perspective.
So curiously, what was your biggest surprise when you went to Miss Universe?
My biggest surprise must be that I thought that a lot of the girls was bitches, maybe. And they really weren't. They were really, really sweet, and I was really surprised. We have so much fun, and yeah, we really learned a lot about each other.
Well, that was a very sweet thing to say, and you have had an the bitch thing was pretty sweet, saying that they weren't. Yeah, no, it was adorable. But you've had an amazing year, and you had a full page spread in Marie Claire. Not even Miss Universe had that, but our Denmark did. It was amazing. She's been in Vogue, Italia, Cosmopolitan, and that's American Marie Claire. So I'm so proud of you. It will be very hard for the next young lady to fill your footsteps. And I know that you're going to go on to big success. You're a blogger, you're working full time, and you're pursuing your undergraduate right now at CBS. So I know the world is your oyster, and Anders and I and the rest of the Face of Denmark team, we just can't wait to see where your life is going to go. And you've been a great example for many other young Danish girls to follow. Yes. Yeah, except for clean up that mouth.
No,
okay. No, it's okay, though. Cecilia Vellemba, the reigning Miss Universe Denmark.
No. Lige om lidt skal vi have pigerne herude igen i deres Mavelle swimwear. Men inden vi skal det, så skal vi lige have noget musik her på scenen. I kender hende måske fra The Voice Junior, hvor hun var finalist.
Wearing custom swimwear made by Mavelle, the girls had a choice of three colors for the swimsuit competition. These swimsuits are part of Mavelle's exclusive Face of Denmark 2016 line, and the colors are Tivoli Pink, Havfru Green, and Copenhagen Blue.
Men nu skal vi have Rachel Lara herud.
Yes.
Kaniner, 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 ka Tak alle sammen. Den næste sang, jeg vil synge, det er en rigtig god sang, og det er en af mine yndlingssange, og den hedder Cool Kids. That's not really her style. They all got the same heartbeat, but who's just falling behind? Nothing in this world could ever bring them down. Yeah, they're so invincible, and she's just in the background. And she said, I wish that I could be like. Got a clue. Yeah, they're living the good life. You see what he's going through. We're driving fast cars, but they don't know where they're going. In the fast lane, living life without knowing. And he's
tak, Rachel. Nu er vi nået til den del af konkurrencen, vi kalder livsstil og fitness. Det er den del af konkurrencen, der plejer at være et stort fan, et stort hit blandt det mandlige publikum. Og de skal herud i nogle bikinier, der er blevet sponsoreret af Marvel, som vi snakkede om lige før. Og vi starter med Alexandria Eissinger fra Roskilde.
Growing up, Alexandria was in the marching band for 6 years and has lived in 9 different cities and over 4 different countries. She considers herself a health nut and has not had a soda in several years.
Alexandria Eissinger, Roskilde. Så er det Sofie Nielsen fra Christianshavn.
Sophie decided to put a pause on her modeling career and focus on her education in astrophysics. Sophie has lived in South Africa for the past 2 years. Eventually, Sophie would like to explore space and be an astronaut.
Sophie Nielsen, Christianshavn. Så er det Sara Danielsen fra Odense.
Sara grew up as the eldest of a large family of 5 and is currently studying to become a nurse. She would like to use her knowledge in the medical industry to make a difference in the lives of others. Recently, she traveled to Thailand on a volunteer trip.
Sara Danielsen, Odense. Så er det Christina fra Lyngby.
Christina considers herself a strong advocate for women's rights. She was raised in both Denmark and Spain, but has lived in Los Angeles for the past several years as an actress. Christiane can speak English, Danish, Spanish, French, and is known for her ability to mimic accents.
Christiane Krøll, Lyngby. Christina Mikkelsen fra København.
Christina has traveled to over 60 countries, but has never visited the USA. She is an adrenaline junkie and has even swam with sharks. Her next planned adventure is skydiving. Christina considers herself a family-oriented person.
Christina Mikkelsen, København. Så er det Malene Sørensen fra Hellerup.
Malene has been modeling since she was 16 years old and while spending time in Australia was featured in Vogue. Malene is currently the vice chairman in a political student organization and hopes to make a positive impact in the Danish education system.
Malene Sørensen, Hellerup. Ines Stojkovic, Frederikssund.
Ines speaks over 9 languages and is a volunteer with an organization that focuses on helping people with special needs, such as children with autism. After Ines finishes her education, she hopes to become a psychologist.
Ines Stojkovic, Frederikssund. Vesan Ashini fra Brøndshøj.
Vesani is comfortable in her own skin. After going through a transformation where she lost 30 kilos in 1 year, Wasan attributes her change to healthy living and support from her family. Wasan is active and loves to dance and play basketball.
Vesan Ashini fra Brøndshøj. Nana Vestergaard fra Esbjerg.
Nana considers herself adventurous. She has been traveling 2 times a year, every year since birth. Nana someday hopes to become a social worker and is currently working as a caretaker for a boy with muscular dystrophy.
Nana Vestergaard, Esbjerg. Lady Russell Panagiton fra Horsens.
Lady loves games and puzzles and can solve a Rubik's Cube if given the chance. Her current goal is to become a pediatric doctor when she finishes her education. Lady was born in Denmark but has Philippine roots.
Lady Russell Panagiton, Horsens. Anna Sofia Yde fra Greve.
Anna Sofia has wanted to be an actress since the age of 5 years old and dreams to win an Oscar one day. Anna Sofia has danced for 15 years and loves to be on stage to give people an experience they will never forget.
Anna Sofia Yde fra Greve. Paulina Posse fra Frederiksberg.
When Paulina was younger, she was the Danish national champion in her age division for the high jump event in track and field. Paulina loves to travel and has visited over 41 countries. Paulina is half Argentinian and half Danish.
Paulina Posse, Frederiksberg. Helene Hylling fra Køge.
Helene considers herself focused and competitive. She has gone through 2 weeks of military camp where she was required to lead a team in a 24-hour operation which included rappelling down a cliff.
Helene Hylling fra Køge. Cecilia Christensen fra Herlev.
Cecilia considers herself multifaceted. She has an interest in calculating physics, dancing, and playing badminton, all while being comfortable in her own skin. Cecilia believes you can do whatever you want and no dream is too crazy.
Cecilia Christensen fra Herlev. Så er det Cecilie Tausen fra Østerbro.
Cecilia once won 20,000 crowns in a science competition for an invention that allows one to climb the walls like Spider-Man. Cecilia is competitive and even was a cheerleader and has won the National Cheerleading Championship with her squad 3 times.
Cecilie Tausen, Østerbro.
Give these girls another round of applause. That's not easy to do right there with 400 people watching.
Nå. Skal vi ikke lige få pigerne herud en sidste gang?
Let's hear it for Copenhagen's Fritzo School, Glam Zone CPH, Adam DK, Niels Lærgaard Mikkelsen, Mia Fabricius, Stina Rasmussen, and Stina Winter von Hoesten. Without their help backstage, all this beautiful hair and makeup you've seen so far would not have been possible. Louder, everybody, let's hear you scream!
Ladies, switch sides. Pigerne ser jo fuldstændig fortryllende ud, når de står heroppe, og det hele bare er sat, og det bare spiller, som det skal. Men jeg skulle hilse at sige, i civilt, i privaten, når de øver, når de træner, så ser de altså næsten lige så godt ud.
Ja, jeg husker tydeligt sidste år, der var det i hvert fald ikke helt på samme måde.
Nej, jeg har fået at vide, at du sidste år til den her konkurrence både havde bygkorn og var ualmindelig sløj samtidig.
Jeg var ikke helt på toppen. Jeg var nok nærmere Miss Quasimodo end Miss Rungsted Kysten, men det var også stadigvæk en sindssygt fed oplevelse, og det er også bare fedt, at dommerne ikke kun dømmer på, om man lige har et bykorn, når jeg kun kan se det der i en øje, men de også har andre værdier i tankerne.
Hvad gjorde så, at du på trods af, at du var så sløj, endte ved at vinde alligevel?
Jeg tror bare, jeg var rigtig meget nede på jorden. Det er også det, jeg har sagt til pigerne i aften. De skal bare nyde det. Nyde lyset heroppe, og bare få det bedste ud af det, for det er once in a lifetime.
Ja. Ja. Er der nogen fra dengang, du kunne tænke dig at takke?
Der er mange, der er rigtig mange, der kunne tænke mig at takke, men specielt min familie, de sidder hernede bag os, og de har bare været ved mig hele vejen. Det betyder sindssygt meget for mig. De rejste hele vejen til Vegas, mens min farmor, hun døde og sådan noget, så de var for mig hele vejen. Det betød rigtig meget for mig.
Nu skal vi have en person på scenen, som I allerede har mødt, og jeg ved, I holder lige så meget af ham, som jeg gør. John Hamilton, The Fuzz.
He wasn't talking about me. He's talking about the people I'm going to introduce. Okay, so thank you, Christian Sebastian. while the ladies are changing, I have the privilege of introducing you to our esteemed panel of international and domestic judges. We begin with none other than our Miss Universe Denmark co-director, Zaklina Soich, who was Miss Universe Denmark 2007 and the last Dane to make the top 15 at Miss Universe in 2007 in Mexico. The next judge I would like to introduce is Heidi Meyer Valentin, who was Miss Universe Denmark 2000 and represented the kingdom in Cyprus. Today she is a mom blogger and absolutely a fantastic person. Next I have Niels Wagner, who is the official legal representative of the Face of Denmark organization and partner at Lordia Law. Next I have the Miss Scandinavia winner from 2005, Miss Universe Denmark 2005, Gita Hansball. Yes. And the last judge over here I have really needs no introduction. She is from Brazil, but lives in Denmark now. And her name is Larissa Ramos Tramontin. She is Miss Earth 2009. And I won't quiz you on your Danish later, don't worry. All right. Our next judge I will introduce is none other than Marco Marie, owner and founder of Gold Professional Hair Care. They've just launched a new color line, and it's Danish-made, Danish-owned and operated. Absolutely fantastic. And he is sponsoring the winners for their competition. Sai Lee, Mr. Universal Ambassador Denmark, and he won the Mr. Universal Ambassador Europe title. The next judge I have is Christina Soderstrom. Christina is the designer of this beautiful crown, which is handmade from sterling silver filigree and inspired by Yggdrasil, the Danish Norse god of, fairy tale. Her designs have been seen on Crown Princess Madeline, Sofia Vergara, and Taylor Swift. And she is a breast cancer survivor as well. So that's something to give a round of applause for also. Yes. Yes. Next judge I would like to introduce is celebrity makeup artist Mia Bothman. She was working backstage last year, so she kind of got a feel for everything. She is the founder of Mia Bothman Face and is seen everywhere, has been published. The next is an empowered female who's one of my very good friends, and you'll see beautiful flowers later from her. She's an entrepreneur and one of the most interesting people I've ever met. Sabrina Pa. Yes, hard to miss with her beautiful look. And last but not least at this table, I have celebrity photographer Anya Ekstrom, Denmark's own. Yes, and the winner of Miss Universe Denmark will have a photo shoot with you, just like Cecilia did. All right, so we move to that table, which is a little dark. I will begin with Courtney Summerfrost, LA-based fashion photographer, who is a pageant title holder as well. She flew in to lend her eye. The next I have is first runner-up at Miss International, first runner-up at Miss Scandinavia, first runner-up at Miss World. She actually beat Halle Berry in 1986. Pia Rosenberg Larsen, and her daughter is backstage helping us. I have another former Danish title holder, Miss Denmark 1982, Tine Maria Nielsen, who placed in the top 15 at Miss World 1982. Yes. And of course, my better half, Anders Hamilton DeVos, the director and founder of Face of Denmark, and right there front and center. And the next judge I would like to introduce is Karen Lewis of Mavel Swimwear. Yes, please stand up. She is the designer for those beautiful swimsuits, and we decided to give them Danish names because I just really like the way Tivoli Pink sounded. It just sounded good. Okay, next we have Katarina Svensson Brink. She is a dressage champion. She is also a lawyer. She is the first Miss Earth and the only Dane to capture an international title and bring the crown back home to us. And we are absolutely so glad to have you as the current co-director of the Miss Earth Denmark organization. And I have to say, her and her husband have one of the most beautiful dressage stables I've ever seen in Sweden, but she is Danish. And then, last but not least, the living icon, Ina Korva, who is the only Dane to make the top five and placed second at Miss Universe, placed in the top five at Miss World, the top two at Miss Europe, and the top three at Miss Scandinavia. Living legend, Ina Korva Williams, and she is also a breast cancer survivor. She flew all the way over here. Miss Denmark, 1963. Let's hear it for these judges. I don't envy them. It's a very difficult job you all have ahead of you. Yes. And at this time, I would like to bring out another title holder and one of my very good friends, Mette-Marie Sørensen, the reigning Miss International Denmark. You might have recognized her. She kind of came in the middle and blew everyone away with her performance.
Thank you so much, John.
Thank you for helping. Now, tell me, you went through this process last year, and you were now kind of on the other side of things. What do you think you've noticed the most from this group of girls now that you're on the other side? And you can say it in Danish so everyone can understand you.
Jamen, det er en helt fantastisk oplevelse at prøve at stå på den anden side. Jeg har jo været med til at vælge de her 15 fantastiske, smukke kvinder. Og det har været en fornøjelse at få lov til at lære dem at kende og få lov til at arbejde med dem. De skal bare nyde aftenen i aften, og det er jeg også 100% sikker på, at de gør.
So, yeah. Can you tell me a little bit about what it was like representing Denmark in Japan at Miss International? And placing in the top 20. Congratulations. Let's give a round of applause for that. 80 girls in our Denmark made it to the top 20.
Jamen, jeg havde en fantastisk tur til Miss International. Det er jo sådan, at når man er afsted til sådan en beauty pageant, så er man ambassadør for Danmark, og det betyder, at man bliver interviewet til japansk tv hver dag, og man får taget billeder med alt og alle, og man føler sig virkelig som en celebrity eller en prinsesse, og det er fantastisk at gå rundt i den her fairytale-verden for 3 uger. Derudover så lægger organisationen også rigtig meget vægt på kultur, og vi var 76 piger fra hele verden, som fik muligheden for at lære hinanden at kende, og det var simpelthen fantastisk at få lov til at lære alle dem at kende. Jeg fik specielt meget den japanske kultur ind under huden. Vi var ude og se traditionel dans, musik. Vi var ude i parker med japanske kirsebærtræer, og det var helt fantastisk. Vi var også til mange velgørenhedsmiddage, og velgørenhed det er netop noget, organisationen lægger rigtig meget vægt på. Miss International støtter nemlig UNICEF. Derudover lægger de også meget vægt på kvindeempowerment, selvstændighed og iværksætteri, og vi fik den ære af at møde nogle japanske kvinder, som simpelthen har bygget deres egen virksomhed op fra bunden af, og det var virkelig inspirerende. Derudover så er det japanske folk noget af det sødeste, og man får gaver, hvor end man kommer hen. Så det er virkelig fantastisk at få lov til at opleve. Jeg mødte også en borgmester, som var meget interesseret i at høre noget om Danmark, fordi at vores kronprinspar kommer til Japan i år 2017. Så det glæder vi os til. Ja. Det var en fantastisk tur, jeg havde.
Yeah. Well, it will be very hard for the next Miss International Denmark to follow in your footsteps. And it has been such a pleasure for Anders and I to get to know you and your amazing family. And I know the girls really, really would not. I mean, that dance was on point. They looked fantastic. And it was really all because of you and Josephine up there and everyone we have backstage. It really is a family and it just grows every year. So thank you for believing in this.
Thank you so much, Jan.
Tusen takk. Yeah. And now we have a very special guest who is performing, and Meta has actually modeled for her and worn her dresses on stage. She really doesn't need much of an introduction. Her name is Laila Alweni from the Faroe Islands, and she's designed all of the beautiful custom-made one-of-a-kind red evening gowns for all the girls.
Og den sang vi skal høre nu, det er en af hendes egne sange, og den hedder Cover.
Thank you.
ladies are backstage, ready to show their poise, elegance, and beauty in the evening wear competition. This portion is designed for each contestant to make an on-stage statement of her compelling charm and presence. The evening gown should complement both the young woman's individual style and personality expressed in the total look. And so, we begin the evening wear competition with Miss Roskilde, Alexandria Eissinger.
Så det Sofie Nielsen fra Christianshavn. Så det Sara, Danielsen fra Odense. Christina Mikkelsen fra København. Christina Mikkelsen, København. Så det Malene Sørensen fra Hellerup. Sørensen Hellerup. Så det Ines Stojkovic fra Frederikssund. Ines Stojkovic fra Frederikssund. Så det Vesan Ashini fra Brøndshøj. Sand er Gini fra Brøndshøj. Så det Nana Vestergaard fra Esbjerg. Nana Vestergaard fra Esbjerg. Så det Lady Russell Panagiton. Lady Russell Panagiton fra Horsens. så er det Anna Sofie Yde fra Greve. Anna Sofie Yde fra Greve. Så er det Paulina Posse fra Frederiksberg. Paulina Posse fra Frederiksberg. Helene Hylling fra Køge. Hylling fra Køge. Cecilia Christensen fra Herlev. Cecilia Christensen fra Herlev. Og sidst, men ikke mindst, Cecilie Tausen fra Østerbro. Cecilie Tausen fra Østerbro. Nu skal vi vist lige have dem ud på scenen en gang til, men der er lidt specielt den her gang, fordi når de kommer ud og står herude, så vil de blive akkompagneret af designeren, nemlig Lara af Reyni, og hun vil synge sin egen sang igen. Den her gang er det en, der hedder Mountain.
Let's hear it for Laila and Helene again in these beautiful lady in red evening gowns. Thank you, ladies. We'll see you again in a moment. Great job. Baby. On the dresses and the singing. And so, at this time, crowned last August, Sylvia Vukovic will represent Denmark in Guayaquil, Ecuador, this coming September. At the 2016 Miss United Continents competition, I'd like to bring her out on stage right now so we can see how she's doing. And
hi, yes. John. Hi, everyone.
So you were a finalist on Denmark's
yes.
Next Top Model.
That's
you
right.
were a winner at last year's competition.
Yes.
You have a different crown now than before. It looks amazing.
That's right, too.
Yeah?
Yes.
So tell me a little bit about your career.
Yes, I'm a psychiatric nurse, and I love to help people make a difference in the world and for sick people. So, yes, I love what I do.
Yeah? And have you been learning some Spanish to prepare for Ecuador?
Yes, a little bit.
Can you say something to all of the people there who might be watching?
Hola! Yeah.
Well, even I can say that. Okay, so how do you find the time to do both nursing, modeling, family? You're very family-oriented. How many of them are you?
Yes, I have 4 siblings, so...
Yeah, okay. And you speak 5 languages?
I speak Serbian, Danish, English, and a little bit Spanish.
Okay. Yeah, so well, that's more than that's 3 more than me, so
yeah.
Well, good luck in Ecuador. We hope that you can bring the crown back to Denmark, and I know that
thank you very much. Yes.
Thank you. It's
bye.
Been a pleasure
have a
to meet
nice
you.
Evening.
All right. And now I would like to thank our sponsors, who without their support, tonight's pageant would not be possible. Yvonne Klista, New York. Thank you. Anya Ekstrom Photography, Marco Marie and Gold Professional Hair Care, Laila Alaini Fashion, OK Go Training, Sabrina Pau, Flora Designs, Michelle Holmes, Prepare to Win, Claudia Pasbe, Pageant Coach, Josephine Hessel Esgard, The Face of Denmark and Miss Universe Denmark Official Walking Coach. And to our staff, who is our family, we would also like to thank Alan Balstrup, Head of Security, Tina Yul, Luis DeVos, Operations. Tina Yule is actually the personal trainer who got you into shape, but she's also over there as our production manager. I see her. Yes. William Veldsen, the head of audiovisual. Mikkel Mendez, who is our tabulator and our judges liaison tonight. Amelia Bledel, Natalie Bikiadel, Nielsen. Sophie Derby, Dora Azarias, Paul Williams. Kristen Sebastian Lawson, who is my other half, one of the 3 of us, so tonight. Niels Wagner, Floor Arrow, Alexandra Rosenberg, Maya Skulder, Mitzi Fitzhansen, Mil Jober, and again, to the Copenhagen Frisser School, Glam Zone CPH, Adam DK, Mia Fabricius, Niels Lagard Mikkelsen, Stina Rasmussen, and Sina Winter van Holsten. As well as Aswin Chinwiti, Nicholas DeVos, Cecilia Begg-Katlum, and Julie Lund. Now we will have an intermission. Thank you. Welcome back.
Så er det blevet tid. Er I klar? Nu har vi set alle pigerne i deres bikini, og vi har set deres dans og deres evening gown. Så nu er det blevet tid til, at det er break it or make it moment, fordi at nu får alle pigerne et spørgsmål. Et på dansk, og så et på engelsk bagefter. Hvor de er ikke nogen af dem, der kender spørgsmålene, så det bliver rigtig spændende at se, hvordan de svarer. Så John, vil du...
Yes, okay. So we're going to bring out the ladies for their final question. And I will be asking them one in English. And you will be asking them one in Danish. Okay, so my lovely magician's assistant here will be holding the bowl. And we would like to start the question and answer portion of the competition
with the first group of five finalists, and they are Miss Roskilde, Alexandria Eissinger, Miss Christianshavn, Sofie Nielsen, Miss Odense, Sara Danielsen, Miss Lungby, Christiane Krull, and Miss Copenhagen, Christina Mikkelsen. We begin with Miss Roskilde, Alexandria Eissinger. Hi, Alexandria. How are you tonight?
Hi, John. I'm great. Thank you. How are you?
Yeah, great. Yeah, I had to think about it. I'm excited and nervous, but pretty good. Yeah, but that wasn't your question. So I have to ask you before we get, you know, ready, a little warm up. You're half American, half Danish. You grew up in the USA.
Yes.
So can you tell me, why did you decide to leave the USA and come to Denmark and stay?
Well, I'm half Danish on my mother's side, so we have actually taken many vacations to Denmark over the past years. I thought it would be really fun after graduating high school to come and study for a couple of years and head back. But I quickly fell in love with the culture, and I've been here 6 years now, and I have no intention of leaving.
Well, okay, me either. And now I will ask you to pull a question out of the box. And it is in Danish, so we will start with the Danish questions first. Because you don't want to hear me, I think I'm still in module one, everyone. All right.
Hvad inspirerer og motiverer dig i hverdagen?
Jeg elsker at sige noget kreativitet. Noget der... Something you don't see every day. Something that makes me think outside the box. And that's what inspires me.
Thank you.
Thank you. Right.
We'll bring you back after the English question next. And our next contestant is Miss Christianshavn, Sophie Klejnstrup. Okay, Sophie, so I understand that someday you plan on winning a Nobel Prize. Okay. I assume it has to do with your passion for astrophysics and quantum physics. Can you tell me, what got you interested in that?
Yeah, well, that's actually a good question. But I remember when I was younger, I went to our balcony and I just saw the sky full of stars, and it just made me wonder why or what is out there. And I wanted to unwrap all these secrets that lies beneath the dark. So yeah, I probably from yeah that point of view, I started to be interested in it. So yeah.
Okay, well, easy question. Hard question. Please, pull one out of the bowl. Box. And give it to him to read.
Nå, der står. Hvis du skulle opfinde én ting, hvad skulle det så være?
Wow. Jamen, det ville nok være en måde, man ligesom kunne rejse hurtigere i tid og rum. Altså, et eller andet sted, sådan, jeg ved ikke, om I kender til ormehuller, men på den måde, hvis man kan rejse lettere mellem andre planeter, vil det også være, at det gør det lettere for os i forhold til klimaforandringer her på jorden, og ligesom kunne gøre en forskel der, og finde en ny planet til os, hvis vi en dag skulle ja, få den ødelagt på en eller anden måde. Så, yeah.
Tak for det. And next we have Sara Danielsen from Odense, Miss Odense. Happy birthday yesterday. Stort lykke. Yeah, you are the eldest of five, and you were recently in Thailand. Can you tell me a little bit about what brought you there and what you experienced?
Recently, I went to Thailand as a part of my education. I'm studying to become a nurse, so I was there at the local hospital, at the emergency ward and delivery room, working together with the nurses. Yeah, it was great.
Good. I'm glad. I couldn't tell if you were done there, so. Okay, pull a question out of the hat box. And don't read it. And give it to him.
Teamwork. Der står. Hvilke tre ting vil du tage med dig på en øde ø?
De tre ting, jeg vil tage med mig på en øde ø, var... Jeg kan jo ikke tage min familie med, så nok et øde mere. Det vil være... En bikini, så jeg kan ligge til sol. så vil det være noget mad, hvis nu var der ikke var så meget frugt. Eller, og så måske en fiskestang, så jeg kan fange en fisk.
Mange tak.
Let's hear it from Miss Odensa. Next we have Christiane Kull, Miss Lyngby. So, Christiane, how are you doing tonight?
I'm great, how are you?
I'm good, I am good, I'm sure of it now. It's easier once you start talking a little bit, right? Yeah. Okay, so I understand you're an actress and a very talented one at that. I also know that you can mimic any accent. So I want to hear you mimic three different accents for me.
Not any accent, but for example, I could do like a Spanish one and pretend like I'm a Latina. Or I could do like I am like I'm from Mother Russia. Or I could do like a good old Danish accent, but that's easy. We can all do that almost.
Sofie. Yeah, okay. Sofie. Except for me. I can't help it. Okay, so please pull a question out of the box and don't read it and give it to Kristen Sebastian. Thank you.
Der står, hvis du vinder kronen i aften, hvad bliver så det første, du gør?
Fejre det. Altså, så simpelt er det, tror jeg. ja, det skal fejres, hvis jeg vinder. Og altså, ja, det kan jo være en masse ting.
Mange tak.
Ja, tak.
Thank you, Miss Lyngby. I didn't understand, but I think that was funny. All right. Now we have Miss Copenhagen, Christina Mikkelsen. Okay. So you have traveled to more countries than I and any other contestant here. And I think it's a very Danish thing to do, to explore the world. Yeah? Yeah, okay. Which has been your favorite place and why?
I think it's going to have to be Cuba. Cuba is such an amazing place. It has this clear blue water and all white sand. And when you drive by down the street, you know, you can smell the barbecue and people are dancing around, listening to music, listening to reggae. It's amazing, you know, you just feel like home and everyone is so nice. So that'd have to be my favorite place.
Okay, well, now I guess I can visit, so I'll have to see if it's all true. Please pull a question out of the hat box and give it to Kristen Sebastian, yes.
Og der står, hvad kan du bedst lide ved dig selv?
Jeg kan bedst lide ved mig selv, at jeg er meget social, og jeg er rigtig god til at omgås mennesker. Og jeg føler, at jeg kan tilpasse mig. Om du er rig, fattig, om du er sort, hvid eller gul, det er ligegyldigt. Og så tror jeg, at jeg har en eller anden evne til at kunne lide alle mennesker, og altid se det bedste i folk, selvom det måske ikke altid er sådan, det er. Så det er nok min bedste egenskab. Tak.
Mange tak.
Yes, thank you, Miss Copenhagen, and I'm just gonna walk over here and grab the questions in English for these girls. Yes, I am, and you can hold it again. All right, so now we're gonna hear them answer the questions in English for our international audience. All right, we begin again with Miss Roskilde Alexandria Eissinger. Please step forward and pull a question out of the bowl. All right. If God granted you one wish, what would you wish for and why?
I wish I would be able to travel the world. I wouldn't have any limits to where I could go. I could learn different languages. I could meet people of different cultures. That's what I would like to do in my life. So if I could have that wish, that's what I would choose. Thank you.
Thank you, Miss Roskilde Alexandria Eissinger. All right, next we bring forward again Miss Kristianshavn, Sofie Klejnstrup Nielsen. If you could, I can't tell what's going on. Okay, please pull a question out of the bowl and give it to me, and don't read it. All right. Do you think that the youth of today faces more pressure of performance than the previous generations?
Yeah. For sure. I know the social media have put a lot of pressure on young people today, especially social platforms as Instagram and Facebook. It's really, really hard to young people because they always need to remain this level of judgment all the time. So I really hope that we can like do something about it to like press this down. So yeah, I think yes. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Ms. Klostentown. All right. Continuing on, we have the eldest of five, Sara Dandis and Ms. Odense. Please pull a question out of the bowl. Thank you. Tell me, what is your definition of success?
I think my definition of success is when you achieve what you personally want in your life. It doesn't have to be education or family, but it's your personal goal, the personal goal that you want to achieve. So that's my definition of success.
Thank you, Ms. Sørensen, Sara Danielsen. All right, next we have again, Christina. Please pull a question out of the silver bowl. Okay, how do you see yourself 15 years from now?
Older. yeah. Probably with a family, with a job, a little less chaos in my life, perhaps, and doing something that matters, hopefully, and doing my best to make a difference. And anything else I can achieve, I suppose.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Lungby, Christiane Kroll. All right. And our last, number five, in our group of first contestants, we have Miss Copenhagen, Christina Mikkelsen. Will you please step forward and pull a question out of the bowl and hand it to me? Okay. If you could go anywhere in the world, where would you go and why?
I already traveled so many places, but I think I would have to say India. I've never been there, but I want to go and I want to visit Taj Mahal. I want to experience the culture and I want to try the food and I want to try the hectic, you know, on the street with all the cars and all the people and just try something different that I haven't tried. So I'm going to have to say India to try something new.
All right. Thank you, Miss Copenhagen, Christina Mikkelsen. And now, we're going to give the judges a last chance to see the first five delegates in their final look. So, judges, we have our first delegate, Alexandria Eissinger, Miss Roskilde. Will it be?
Så der Sofie Nielsen fra Christianshavn. Er favoritten måske Sara Danielsen fra Odense? Eller er det måske Christiane Krøll fra Lyngby? Eller er det Christina Mikkelsen fra København?
All right.
Mange tak, Pia.
Thank you to our first group of finalists. All right, we will begin our next group of contestants for their final question. Woo, almost had a fall there. Good thing there's glow-in-the-dark tape. All right. Yes, we begin with Miss Hellup, Malene Sørensen. Okay, so you're originally from Randers. Did I say that right? Randers? Like Anas, but Randers?
Yeah.
Exactly. Okay, Randers. And now you live in Copenhagen. Not so good as my Randers. But can you tell me, my pronunciation, not the area, can you tell me what you feel is the biggest difference between Zeelanders and Jysk people?
Yes. Well, when I first moved here, like 3 years ago, I got teased a lot by my dialect. Oh wait, I still get teased a little bit. The Danish humor includes both sarcasm and irony sometimes, but it's in the most loving way. So I really think the biggest difference between Jylland and Sjællander is what the individual makes of it. Thank you.
Okay, now pull a Danish question out of the hat box and give it to Kristen Sebastian.
Der står, hvis du fik muligheden for at ændre noget fra fortiden, hvad skulle det så være?
Jeg tror ikke umiddelbart, at jeg vil ændre noget fra fortiden, for det ville kun komme i vejen for min fremtid. Min fortid har jo været med til at gøre mig til den, jeg er i dag, og jeg er stolt og tilfreds med de ting, jeg har opnået og hvem jeg er, så jeg vil ikke ændre noget fra min fortid.
Mange tak. Så er det Ines Stojkovic fra Frederikssund.
Hi Ines, how are you doing tonight?
Hi, I'm great, thanks.
Yeah, you look amazing. I heard you weren't feeling too well backstage, but you seem to have gotten some color in your face. So.
Oh, that's good.
Yes. So you speak 9 languages. Wow.
Yeah.
I've never met anyone. Have you ever met anyone who speaks 9 languages other than you, or anyone who speaks more than 9 languages?
No, not really.
Me either. You're the first. Do you plan on learning any more?
Of course. Why not? I mean, it's the most important thing in our society, in our world. So definitely, yeah.
Yeah, well, yeah, I guess it's important to be able to communicate with people. I'm still struggling with one. Please pull a question out of the hat box.
Interesting.
And don't read it.
Der står. Er du miljøbevidst, og hvordan?
Helt klart. Jeg har altid ønsket mig en Tesla. Ikke klart. Jo, jeg synes, det er super vigtigt for os, for vores miljø, at gøre noget. Men jeg synes, vi skal starte småt. Everyone go buy a Tesla.
Tak. Så er det Vesan Ashini fra Brøndshøj.
Hi, Vesan. How are you?
I'm good, thanks.
So you originally started as a makeup artist, and that was what your education was in, and now you've switched to wanting to work with children. What made you change?
I changed because I want to make a change in the world, and I think our kids is where we're going to make the change. And I just want to be happy every day, and I'm gonna be happy every day if I'm gonna work in a group home or in a foster home with the people who doesn't got that safety key that we other got.
Okay, please pull a question out of the hat box and give it to Kristen Sebastian to read. Yep.
Der står, hvis du var en af dommerne i dag, hvad vil du så spørge deltagerne om?
I would ask them what they're achieved, what they want to, nej, it's on Danish. Jeg vil spørge dem om, hvad de vil opnå, og hvordan de vil opnå det, og hvad de vil gøre for at opnå det. Fordi det synes jeg er vigtigt for at gøre, hvem man er, og hvad man står for.
Tak.
Thank you.
Thank you. Nana Vestergaard fra Esbjerg.
Hi, Nana.
Hey, John.
So, how many countries have you traveled to since you've been traveling?
I think I've been traveled to about 10 countries.
Okay. And what has been what have you learned in one of the countries that has inspired you the most?
I mean, the one country that inspired me the most must be Thailand, just because people are so calm and down to earth and they are so welcoming and polite. I like Thailand very much.
Do you know any Thai?
No.
I do. We can say Sawadi to everyone in Thailand.
Sawadi.
Yes. All right. Please pull a question out of the hat box and give it to Kristen Sebastian for him to read.
Tak skal du have. Der står. Har dit syn på skønhedskonkurrencer ændret sig efter du selv har deltaget i den?
mit syn på skønhedskonkurrencer har bestemt ændret sig. Jeg vidste ærligt talt slet ikke, at de fandtes i Danmark, inden jeg var med i den her. Og jeg har altid set det som en lidt overfladisk ting. Men efter jeg har været med, så har jeg udviklet mig så meget, og jeg har lært så meget om mig selv, så det har helt klart ændret sig rigtig meget.
Tak.
Thank you, Nana. All right.
Yeah. Oh.
Next we have Lady Russell Panagutin, Miss Horsens. Thank you. Okay, lady. Clearly, you are Asian, but you were born in Denmark.
Yes.
Can you please tell me, do you feel more Filipino or more Danish?
As mentioned, I was born and raised here in Denmark. So of course I feel more Danish because I was born and raised here and it is what I know of. I have always been close to what I know about Denmark and I of course love the Philippines, but Denmark will always be my heart.
Okay. And what is your favorite tradition from both countries?
I love all the traditions. I am a lucky girl, first of all. I am a lucky girl because I am a multicultured girl. And second of all, my family is there, both Danish and Filipinos, so I'm a very lucky girl.
Okay, I think so too. Please pull a question out of the hat box and let Christian Sebastian read it for you. Okay, yeah, there's a little gap.
Der står, hvad har du lært af den her konkurrence?
Jeg har lært meget nyt om mig selv. Jeg har lært, at ved at arbejde hårdt, så kan du opnå rigtig meget. Og det er en ting, jeg gerne vil vise resten af verden, hvis jeg vinder en titel. At så længe du arbejder hårdt for det, så kan du opnå næsten alt. Og det er noget, jeg virkelig tror på. Mange tak.
Tak.
And while we do that, I will switch over to the English side, just putting them over here so they're safe and nobody sees them. Thank you. All right. We begin again with Miss Hello Up, Malene Sørensen. Please pull a question out of the bowl and give it to me. Yes. Tell me what your one message would be to the world and why.
My one message to the world would be that you should be proud of who you are and what you do. You shouldn't let anyone in the society put you in one box. So embrace yourself and embrace all your interests, even though they may be different. I'm both into glitz and glamour and the pageants, but I'm also into politics, and I'm really proud that I have both sides. So my message would be that you should be proud of yourself and do all your interests.
Thank you. Thank you, Ms. Hellop. All right, continuing on with Inez Stojkovic, Miss Fladjakson. Hi again.
Hi.
Please pull a question out of the bowl and pass it to me.
I won't look now.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
That makes one. All right. How would you change the world if you were to play God for a day?
Oh, that's a really good question. I think that I will find a cure for cancer. I mean, everybody in here probably knows someone who had it or have it, and that's something I really want to change. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Fladjakson, Ines Stojkovic. Again, we have Ms. Bonsoy, Asin Asin. Please pull a question out of the bowl and pass it to me. Thank you. Okay, tell me about a recent goal that you accomplished.
I accomplished my weight loss about a year ago, where I lost 30 pounds in 1 year, and that was a big thing for me because it was something that always was on my shoulders. So now I'm just a heavy girl.
Thank you, Ms. Bonsoy. Ms. Espia, please pull a question out of the bowl and pass it to me.
Here you go.
Thank you. Tell me about why you decided to enter this competition.
The reason why I wanted to enter this competition was to, you know, build myself and learn new things and gain confidence. This is really, that has been the biggest thing here for me. It has built my confidence so much that I'm even standing here right now in front of foreign people, and
and being able to speak and being proud of myself and what I do. So that's it. Thank you.
Thank you, Miss Espia and Anna Vestergaard. Continuing with Miss Horsens, Lady Horsens, Lady Russell Panagutin, please pull a question out of the silver bowl from Jorg Jensen, Danish. And please tell me, which role of a man complements a woman better? Father, son, or spouse?
I think all of them are very important. As a man, you are able to show women a different kind of perspective. Men and women were born differently, so I believe that all of them are very important. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Holsen's Lady Panagutin. We're now going to give the judges one last look at the second group of five finalists. We begin with Ms. Hillop.
Malene Sørensen. Stojkovic fra Frederikssund. Vesan Ashini fra Brøndshøj. Så er der Nana Vestergaard fra Esbjerg. Så er der Lady Russell Panagiton fra Horsens. Thank you, ladies.
Our next group of finalists, I will weave through the ladies in red, if I can, if I may. Thank you. I've always wanted to come out behind a red curtain. All right, we begin with Miss Glale and Sophie Aid. Yes, how are you? I forgot what I was going to talk to you about, so I have to grab this. Just one moment. I don't know. I'm just so enamored with your beautiful faces, dresses, and everything else. It's hard for me to get it 100%, you know? All right. So, Anna Sophia, congratulations on a beautiful opening performance, by the way. You girls really killed it in the beginning there at the end. I enjoyed watching it. I heard you can mimic animals. I want you to know that my favorite animal is a swan. It always has been. I always painted pictures of swans, and now I live in a country where the national bird is a swan, and both of our national costumes last year were swans. So anyways, I like swans. I want to see you do a swan impression right now.
Well, I can actually do that. Well, I'm not really a quacker that good, but I am practicing it right now, actually. Yes. A swan goes like, it has like a howl, like a... Yes. Yeah.
Very good. I've never heard a swan. I've just heard them. Very good. Now please pull a Danish question out of the hat box and pass it to Christian Sebastian, and then he will ask it to you.
Der står, vil du hellere være lækker eller klog, og hvorfor?
Jeg vil nok hellere have intelligens. Men jeg synes, begge ting er rigtig vigtige. Hvordan du fremstår foran andre, men også hvordan du bruger den fremtagelse, er utrolig vigtigt. Hvordan du føler, og hvordan din udstråling er. Men du skal også bruge den udstråling til noget. Du har ikke bare fået den for bare at se pæn ud. Det er også en måde at komme frem og lade folk virkelig lytte til dig.
Tak. Paulina Posse, Frederiksberg.
Okay, hi, Paulina. So, tell me a little bit about your time in Buenos Aires. Don't tell me about your time in Buenos Aires. What do you think the biggest difference is between Argentinians and Danes?
Okay. I think a really big difference is that Argentinians are more open people. It's easier to strike up a conversation with them, whereas Danish might not be so open and easy, but are more humble and maybe respect each other's privacy a little more. Yeah.
So how do you combine both cultures? Do you feel very Danish when you're in Argentina and very Argentinian when you're in Denmark, or do you kind of just feel at home at both places?
Yeah, I feel at home at both places because I've grown up with the culture, and it's just both are part of me. So when I'm in Argentina, I feel really Argentinian, and here I feel Danish.
Yeah. Okay. Well, thank you. Please pull a Danish question out of the hat box and pass it to Christian, and he will pass me the box while he asks it to you.
Logistik. Hvis du kunne rejse i tiden, hvor vil du så rejse hen?
Så vil jeg helt sikkert rejse til fremtiden. Jeg er meget nysgerrig efter at se, hvordan alt det, vi kæmper for i dag, om det er noget, vi har opnået en gang om 100 år, for eksempel alle miljøproblemerne og kvinderettigheder og sygdom, om alt det er noget, vi har opnået en gang om 100 år, for eksempel. Så helt sikkert at rejse ud i fremtiden.
Tak.
And now we have Helene, Jensen. I understand that you wish to be a psychologist someday. I think I hear your grandmother out there. Is that her?
Probably.
Yeah, okay. I've heard about you. Tell me about what makes you interested in this career choice of being a psychologist.
Well, I'm really interested in how the human mind works, and I am also very interested in why we act as we do. And I do believe that the psychology sector of the Danish healthcare system can be improved, and I would really like to be a part of that change.
Okay, well, let's see where it goes. I'll touch base with you in about 10 years. Please give it to Christian Sebastian, and he will ask you your question in Danish.
Der står, hvor vigtigt er det for dig at se godt ud?
Altså, jeg arbejder som model, og derfor er det rigtig vigtigt for mig at tage mig af mit udseende. Men jeg er også meget klar over, at dit udseende ikke får dig hele vejen. Det er også rigtig, rigtig vigtigt at være den, man er. Det er rigtig, rigtig vigtigt at have selvtillid, og det er også rigtig, rigtig vigtigt, at man tør stå ved en selv, og at man i det hele taget, ja, tør være der.
Mange tak. Cecilia Christensen Herlev.
Hi, Cecilia.
Hi,
John. Hi. Okay, so you love mathematics, dancing, playing sports, and being a beauty queen. But tell me, what is your favorite part of you and why?
The favorite part of me is that I love the simple life. I love to spend time with my family or with my friends. And I love that I have both sides of me. That I'm a very guy kind of girl. I love to play football and all that stuff. But I also love this to dance and to go a catwalk and to dress up and feeling beautiful. Yes.
Well, I think every girl deserves to feel like a princess, so absolutely. And every guy, maybe. Please pull a question out of the hat box and pass it to Christian Sebastian. Thank you.
Der står, hvad er en vinder i dine øjne?
Hvad er en vinder i mine øjne? Man kan jo se det på mange måder. En vinder i mine øjne er først og fremmest en, der kan sådan kigge sig selv i spejlet og være stolt af den, man er. Og stå ved, at man ikke har ændret sin personlighed ved at være med i sådan en konkurrence, for eksempel. At man stadig kender sig selv og bevarer den, man er. Og så at man bevarer den her ydmyghed, man har som godt kan blive testet lidt nogle gange, men at man bevarer den, det synes jeg er det vigtigste som en vinder.
Tak. Og Cecilie Tausen fra Østerbro.
And so you lived in Australia alone for a year as when you were 16 years old. Yeah, I lived in Australia alone for a year when I was 26 years old. So please tell me, what did you learn from that experience living abroad on your own? I feel like that's a very young age, at least in America. Danes are a little bit more independent, I guess. But I feel like that's a very young age to live alone. I mean, what was that experience like?
It definitely made me more aware of who I am, and it also made me way more independent. And I absolutely loved that country, and I fell in love with the culture. And one thing that I in particular really loved was their slang. And all those little phrases they use, like, g'day, mate, and Macca's. How you going, and all that. Yeah, Macca's as well.
Because you speak English like an Australian. You have a better Australian accent than me, and my mom's from there, so. And one of my really good friends is from New Zealand, too, so they're together there. We got the Down Under contingency. But could you please not bother pulling out one question, because there it is only one question left, and he will read it right for you.
Der står, hvad gør dig smuk?
Hvad gør mig smuk? Jeg tror, smukhed eller skønhed, det har rigtig meget, det har mere med det indre at gøre end med det ydre. Og jeg tror, at jeg har fundet en helt særlig fred med mig selv, og jeg hviler i mig selv på en måde, som ikke særlig mange mennesker gør. Så det gør mig i stand til at bære mig med en særlig selvtillid, og det synes jeg er det, der gør mig smuk.
Tak.
All right, we will begin with our English round of death. Please come out here and pull a question from the silver bowl and pass it to me. We should probably fold these next time. What would you say is the biggest problem facing the Danish educational system today and why?
The biggest problem in education right now. I think it is... No. Yes. Right now, we're in between how long hours our kids has to be in school, whether they should be a long time and should be able to do their homework, or they should be shorter and have a lot of homework at home. We are trying to make the school better, but I think we are having a hard time how to make it better.
Okay, thank you, Ms. Gleil and Sophia Yid. Paulina Posse, please come forward and pull the next question out of the silver bowl and pass it to me. Why you should be winning this competition, please tell me.
Well, I think the winner of Miss Universe should be open-minded, approachable, sympathetic, and competitive, but in a good way. And yeah, I think you should have all those qualities, and I think I've got all of them, so yeah. I think I should win.
Thank you, Ms. Posse, Ms. Fletchingsbear. Moving right along, we have Ms. Kuh. I can't say it with as much power as you do, but please pull a question out of the silver bowl and pass it to me. Thank you, dear. Who is your role model and why?
One of my role models is definitely Olivia Colbo, Miss Universe 2012. She is as short as I am, but she has managed to become a model, be successful, and win Miss Universe, even though she is small. I think that shows a big quality as perseverance, which I believe I have. And I basically want to be like her. She does what I want to do. And yeah, that's why she's my role model.
Thank you, Ms. Koo, Helene Jensen. Next, we have Ms. Helu. Please pull a question from the bowl and pass it to me. Yeah, there was not. Nope. What do you expect to gain by participating in pageants?
I expect to gain a lot of new friendships, which is the most amazing thing about this. I have Christina here, she's my big sister, and with
Miss Anne, we talk about all the serious stuff, and lately I goof around, it's Friends for Life of all parts of Denmark. And yes, the same thing about feeling beautiful, a feeling you sometimes you don't feel every day, so it's amazing to feel this tonight.
Thank you, Miss Helu. All right, and I have our last question here, so come sa. All right, Cecilia. Tell me, if you could go back in time and change one thing in your past, what would it be and why?
I would go back to when I was, I think, around 12. I was bullied a lot when I grew up, and I let it bring me down, and it made me not do things that I really wanted to do. And so if I could go back, I would go back and do all the things that I wanted to do, despite people telling me not to do it and telling me that I couldn't do it and prove them wrong.
Okay, thank you, Miss Istubo, Cecilia Towson. And now we will let the judges make the most important decisions of their lives. And look at our final group of five contestants.
Og sidste kig er først på Anna-Sophie Yde fra Greve. Paulina Posse Frederiksberg. Helene Hylling fra Køge. Cecilia Christensen fra Herlev. Og Cecilie Tausen fra Østerbro.
I think that it's crazy that the girls did so well on those questions. I want to go back there and ask them if they had an idea of the questions beforehand.
I hope they didn't.
Me too, I know that they didn't. Because somebody wrote them 10 minutes before the show started.
Mens dommerne sidder og voterer og finder vores vinder i aften, så skal vi have et par stykker med musik mere. Den næste, vi skal høre synge, er nok en, de fleste af jer kender. Hvis I har set X-Factor i 2010, så gør I i hvert fald. Dengang, der var hun en nyudklækket sangerinde. Siden da har hun fået pladekontrakt i Canada. Hun har været i studiet med Sanne Salemundsen. Hun har skrevet sange med Dominic King. Og de to sange, hun vil synge i aften, det er den første sang. Det er en premiere. Det er helt eksklusivt for jer. Hendes allernyeste single, som er Crawling Back to Love. Og bagefter kommer This Is My Life af Gasoline. Giv en varm hånd til Tine.
Tak skal I have.
Velbekomme.
Crawling back to you, that something you do keeps me falling through. You're touching me with honesty. Something I can't find with someone new. If we keep on crawling until we fall back into place right where we belong, we'll be back to love.
My heart is beating every time you're leaving, but I know that you'll be back, back for something more. Even though they're saying that you never quit the playing, I'll keep on praying it's you that I call home. If we keep on crawling until we fall back into place right where we belong, we'll be crawling back to love. 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 We'll be. If we keep on to place right where we belong, we'll be crawling back to love. We'll be falling back in love. We'll be crawling back to love. We'll be falling back in love. We'll be crawling back to love.
Tusind tak. Så er der festmusik. Det var ikke lige en del af planen. Så det er et nyt nummer, vi lige spiller for her i aften. Ej, tak skal I have. Det var et nyt nummer, som er taget direkte fra studiet. Det er sidste lyrik belagt på for 3 dage siden. Så jeg håber, I kunne lide det. Tak. Jeg synes, inden vi går videre og spiller den næste nummer, for jeg synes jeg bare lige, at vi skal give en kæmpe applaus til de her sindssyge, smukke, 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 smukke piger. Er du sindssyg? Hvor gør de det godt? Altså, så lad os lige give dem en kæmpe hånd. Woo! Det næste nummer, vi vil spille for jer, det er egentlig helt sikkert kender. Det er dejlig, dejlig dansk band, der hedder Gasoline. Og syng endelig med, hvis I kender den. Her kommer This Is My Life.
Show me the line and I'll go there. Give me the wine, bitter and sweet, and a little bit of bread, that's all I need. I don't want the gold from Sanity. I think I'll leave it all to you. Whoa, whoa, this is my life and I don't care. This is my street, I'm your restless feet. Carry me up to any. Give me some hope for one more day. I saw a ghost behind the door.
the kids were coming home from war, war, with broken dreams and nothing more. This is my life. This is my time. Just show me the light and I'll go in.
Og August, mine damer og herrer på guitar. Tusind tak skal I have. Tak skal I have.
Absolutely beautiful. I've been a fan for a while. Yeah, since I met you at Matus. Okay. Wow. It's almost time.
That is what girl power is, and that is what this competition is all about. Now, I'm going to refer to my cue cards, because I'm going to list the prizes these women are going to win, if they win, and there are a lot of them, so... Start out with Miss Universe Denmark will represent Denmark at the Miss Universe pageant and will have round-trip travel expenses, wardrobe, competition swimsuit, competition evening gown, national costume, and all accommodations taken care of during the Miss Universe competition. She will win a custom one-of-a-kind unique tiara by Yvonne Christa, New York, to keep as a as a memento of her reign as Miss Universe Denmark. Miss Earth Denmark will represent Denmark at Miss Earth, receive mentorship and guidance by the first Miss Earth winner, Katarina Svensson Brink of Denmark, and will as well as mentorship and preparation by Larissa Ramos, Miss Earth 2009 of Brazil. Miss Earth Denmark will also receive a competition swimsuit, competition evening gown, national costume, and wardrobe during her time at Miss Earth. We also today have the unveiling of the new Miss Earth crown, which is this one.
We'll talk more about that later.
Yeah, more about that later. She will win an entire year of free hair care and hair services provided by Gold Hair Care. Makeup lessons and cosmetic gift packages from Niels Leigård Mikkelsen, the official face of Denmark makeup artist. A photo shoot with US-based LA fashion photographer Sydney Sommerfrost.
Courtney
Sommerfrost, sorry. Fashions and wardrobe provided by Lidø. Pageant preparation, styling, walk and interview coaching with Universal pageant coach Prepare to Win, Michelle Holmes. Fashions and wardrobe by Faroe's designer, Laila Lerevni, who you saw earlier. Pageant preparation and more by Carl Genser. Official photo shoot with Yvonne Taylor, photo. Wardrobe, styling, hair and makeup lessons and more in preparation for the international competition. Portfolio building and model development with Anja Ekström.
She's right over there, one of our judges, our official Danish photographer, Anja Ekström.
1 year personal training sessions with certified nutritionist and personal trainer, fitness trainer, Tina Juhl of OK Go Training, who is also into tech. Dental consultation and smile package by celebrity dentist Alex Naini in Washington, D.C. Beautiful bouquet of flowers by Pei Floral Designs. And all the finalists will receive gold hair care products, a gifted two-piece competition bikini by Mavel Swimwear, Sherry Hill cocktail dresses, sponsored evening gown for final competition by Laila Reyni, and photo shoot with Anja Ekström.
Let's bring these girls back on stage now. And so, last year, I had the privilege of moving to Denmark from Australia, which was a country that I fell in love with, but I fell in love with somebody and that brought me over here. With that being said, I have had sort of a strange time adjusting to the Danish climate, being very udansk myself, but I love it. You guys are really, really cool. And I have definitely chilled out since I've been here. I'm a little less, if you can imagine. And so one of my favorite Danes has to be somebody that I have admired for decades, and this is truthful. The only Dane to make top five at Miss Universe and be first runner-up, which I think she was robbed. She should have won. Sweden's won, Norway's won, Finland's won. We should have won. Aino Korva. And so she was not able to come to be here last year and be a judge, but she was very supportive from abroad. And so now I would like us to take a moment, and if we could all look towards the screen, we will reflect on her career. Give a round of applause for our head judge, Miss Denmark 1963, Aino Korva. Thank you for coming here and helping us select someone who hopefully should be as lucky as you have been and follow in your footsteps. Aino, you have become a part of our family, and I would like to consider you my danska mormor. Are they right? Okay. Yes, I would like to consider you that. Thank you. Thank you for coming here and being so supportive of us. When we have all of these former title holders that have gone to Miss Universe, Miss International, Miss Scandinavia, Miss Supercalifragilistic, we really, really feel supported in this competition because we know that we are making a positive impact in all of these young ladies' lives. And I have spent the past week with all of you, and I certainly hope that we can all remain friends after this because you've become a part of the face of Denmark family. So, let's have a round of applause for all of our judges and contestants. Yes. All right, so.
Speaking of friends, there is a title, as you maybe all know, called Miss Congeniality, who the ladies voted on themselves, who they thought should win that. And I will just check behind me to see if they're ready. Yes. So, I can reveal Miss Congeniality. She is Miss Sofie Nielsen Christianshavn.
Thank you. All right, we also have another award. A panel of expert judges have viewed all of the girls' pictures and decided that Miss Espia Nana Vestergaard is Miss Photogenic 2016. Toluca. At this time, we would like to bring out the amazing Catalina Svensson-Brink and Larissa Ramos-Tremontin. Both are unique in the sense that they have captured the Miss Earth crown representing Denmark and Brazil. Hi, ladies. Hello, 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 sauce. Okay. So you've really had your work cut out for you this evening.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yes. Can you tell me, before we unveil the new Miss Earth, a little bit about your experience with Miss Earth and being the first Miss Earth? It's just a deign to be the first to do something.
Yes, exactly. It was an amazing experience, as all the other girls have said as well. You get to meet a lot of people. You get to see a different side of the world. The Miss Earth was in the Philippines, so that was the first trip for me to Asia, which was amazing as well. Then it is with the Miss Earth, you have a lot of environmental work, and it was great to see for 3 weeks that all people were working for the same goal, which is quite unique because you have the girls from all over the world. They're there at a competition, competing, and at the same time working for the same goal.
Okay. So, how has it been working with the Miss Earth organization afterwards?
Well, I worked the first year after my reign, which is in 2002, and it was a no-go in Denmark. It was uphill. So now we are in a different time, it's a different era, and I think we have a lot to do. We have amazing girls from Denmark that are female-empowered, they are strong, they're independent, they are highly educated, and they are concerned about environment and other international important issues. So we have a lot to offer, we just have to prove it.
All right. And so you are the owner, with your partner, of Tollstop Dressage Stable. Can you tell me, what is dressage exactly?
Yeah, well, dressage is like a sport for many others. It's a sport where you have the horse as a sort of a tool. You can enjoy it as a complete amateur, as me, or you can enjoy it as my husband, as an Olympic rider. And you've got the partnership with a horse, which is very special. And when you've got that perfect partnership, it's powerful.
Yeah, well, yeah, I know how that is. My partner and I run a beauty pageant. So you're also a lawyer. Can you tell me a little bit about your modeling and your law experience? Like, how do you do it all?
Well, I started working as a lawyer. I finished my education and started working as a lawyer. But then I met my husband, and then I moved to Sweden, and horses is a lifestyle, so it wasn't time for both. So now I'm a mother of two, and I work in the company full-time, where I do, of course, all our contracts. Never had as many contracts as now, but I do the law thing, and I do marketing and everything else, so combination.
Oh, well, that just shows it's beauty and brains. There's nothing wrong with a pageant. Okay. Now, we haven't placed at Miss Earth since you won. What do you think it will take for Denmark to bring home an international crown again, such as Miss Earth?
I think we have everything it takes, actually. We got the beautiful and intelligent women. We got it all. We just need to show these people, that the girls, that they actually belong at the pageants. I think that's our biggest problem, that many girls don't believe that they actually belong at the international pageants, but they really do.
Yeah, I agree. So to conclude, do you have any words that are important for the title holders to bear in mind when they go to the international competitions?
It's really important that they are themselves. They have to show themselves outwards. They have to keep both feet on the ground, which is really, really important as well. You can aim high, but still keep the feet on the ground. And they have to also act in the role as an ambassador, which is the point and the goal with the international beauty pageants, that you have a year as an ambassador for a cause, and they have to take that role and act as it.
All right. Well, I absolutely agree. And so now I would like for you to tell us a little bit about the new Miss Earth Denmark crown. It's very Viking. It's very, very Viking. I love it.
This crown has been inspired by the Nordic middle-aged jewelry. It's combined with a twist of fairy tale. The key issue in the design has been the closeness to our earth, inaugurated by the few, worshipped by the crowd. As this was a dark period, a dark age, our crown is reflecting this by its appearance. It's made out of oxidized sterling silver, and it's embraced by earth environmental friendly handmade black diamonds, more than 68 carats in total. The making of the crown is performed with the same old tradition methods goldsmiths used many thousands of years ago. Every little piece is created separately and carefully, welded together, due to respect for our earth. No modern machinery was used, only the old craftsmanship.
That is a lot of information. I mean, we have two beautiful Scandinavian design crowns that I have not seen anywhere else in the world. And somebody coming from Brazil, Larissa, what do you think about our crowns compared to the ones you've seen in other countries?
I think the best word to describe is unique. And no, but I mean, it's beautiful, and I think that's represent the culture, and that's the most important thing about the crown. And that's why you're gonna be there, you're gonna be represent Denmark. So it's all about that, and you should be proud of that.
So tell me, you've been now living in Denmark for a year, and we talked a little bit about this, and you know, it was cold when you came over, and I was like, how can you move from Brazil to Denmark? I miss Australia so much. But what I mean, I think we both agree, the one thing about the Danes is that we feel safer. Like, I'm not worried I'm gonna get shot pumping my gas, you know? Like, I mean, what do you think is the big difference from Brazil and Denmark?
Well, when I moved last year was during the summer, and then I come straight from Rio. So when I arrived here, I was like, no way, it's summer. But I really enjoy, and after the winter, I really appreciate the sun and the gardens and how beautiful the city is. And it's just amazing because I have been so much welcome here, me and my husband, and I just felt home. And when you talk about safe and security is just another way to see everything, and I just feel so comfortable here, and I not see myself moving right now, so yeah, I'm very happy.
Okay, I do have to ask you one question though. Scandinavians are known to be always painfully on time, like 10 minutes early for everything. Brazilians are known to be sometimes socially acceptable, even showing up a day later, am I right? I've heard
yeah,
that.
Yeah, that's right.
So are you on time? Have you always been on time? Or was it a big shift for you? Because it's a big shift for me. Yeah.
So you're the right one to answer that for me. I always on time when the meeting for you, right? So.
No, but did you read before that that was the thing to do? Or did you just kind of always have been on time?
Yeah, actually, I like to be on time because I think that's a bit disrespectful with others. We'd be waiting for you, so I like this culture, so that's why I'm joining.
I'll never forget, my really good friend in Australia was from Finland, and I was in Australia, it's also, you know, show up 3 hours late, you know, is that a hard nine, or can I roll in around noon? I had a friend from Finland, and I was like, don't you ever get sick of waiting around an hour for everyone else to show up? She's like, yeah, I just started showing up everywhere an hour later because I couldn't handle just waiting for everything. But that's great. You're one of the few people I know that's not from here that's always on time. So I'm getting better, though. I'm getting better. Yes. Well, thank you so much, ladies. I wonder if now we have the results.
The results are in.
Okay. Oh, my gosh. I'm so excited, girls. We're all so proud of you. You're all winners, as Aino Corvus said, because you did something. And I don't want to see anybody crying or mad after this because you all got a Sherry Hill dress for free.
Except from Joy.
They don't even sell that in Denmark, okay? So there's no reason to be sad. Nobody is a loser. A queen has been elected. With that being said, we have some flowers here. That's good. We will, of course, have Larissa and Katarina crown our Miss Earth winner. But first, we will announce the second runner-up. The second runner-up, if for any reason one of our title holders cannot fulfill her duties, the second runner-up will take her place. I will now announce the name of the second runner-up. The second runner-up is Miss Ku, Helene Jensen. Congratulations, Helene.
And now for the first runner-up,
I will now announce the name of the first runner-up. The first runner-up is Malene Sørensen, Miss Hello Up. Yep. Congratulations, Miss Hello Up. Now, to begin our crowning, I will announce who is our Miss Earth Denmark. Our Miss Earth Denmark 2016 is... Are we ready? Can we get suspenseful music? Just kidding. Miss Roskilde Alexandria Eissinger. Congratulations, Alexandria. You're going to Miss Earth October 23rd, somewhere in Asia. We can't wait to find out where that may be. Congratulations. Ah! No, that's really scary. I've cut myself on it. It's really scary. Yes, so don't move too far. Congratulations, Alexandria. You are going to Miss Earth. At this time, we would like to bring out the reigning Miss International Denmark 2015 for a few words and her final walk as Miss International Denmark, Medalie Sørensen.
Thank you. Good evening, again. Is it working? Is it working? Yes, okay, I couldn't hear myself. The past year has been an amazing journey, and I have enjoyed every moment of it. As you know, I traveled to Japan and competed in Miss International. Being a title holder, I have learned so much more about different personalities, cultures, and countries. This has given me a better understanding of the world that we are living in. I have also learned even more about myself, my values, and what I stand for. So even though I did not win the Miss International crown, I have won in so many other ways. So for those girls that are competing here tonight and don't win a crown, remember that beauty pageants are about so much more than winning. I am sure that you all have won in some way, like I did. For the past few months, I have followed these 15 beautiful women grow stronger. And I am looking forward to prepare the next Miss International Denmark. I would like to thank all the judges from last year, and I know there is many of them here. And I will also like to thank John Paul, Anders, my family, friends, and boyfriend for believing in me and supporting me all the way to Japan. It means the world to me. I believe that Denmark is one of the best countries in the world, and it has been an honor to represent our country. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Meta. And here's the crown that you will put on the next girl's head. All right. The name I will now announce is that of Miss International Denmark 2016, who will represent Denmark October 26th in Tokyo, Japan. Are we ready? Miss International Denmark 2016 is... Miss Odin, Sara Danielsen! Congratulations, Miss Odin! Congratulations. Congratulations, Sarah. The name that I will now announce is Miss Supranational, and to come help us on stage is the reigning Miss Supranational Denmark, Mia Pilarsen. How are you doing tonight?
I'm doing fine, thank you.
Yes, you look absolutely positively radiant. Are you ready to crown the next girl who's going to follow in your footsteps?
Yes, definitely.
All right. Yes? The name I will now announce is that of the 2016 delegate for Miss Supranational. Miss Supranational 2016 is Miss Christianshavn Sofie Klejnstrup Nielsen. Congratulations, Sofie. All right, looking good. All right. Sara, your crown is falling off. Your crown is falling off. Yeah, just didn't want an accident. That one's not as dangerous as the earth one, but you know, gotta make sure. All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is the moment we've all been waiting for. Who's it gonna be, guys? All right. The name I will now announce is that of Miss Universe Denmark 2016. Miss Universe Denmark 2016 is Christina Mikkelsen, Miss Copenhagen! Congratulations to all of our finalists. Christina, come back. You don't have a crown on your head. Congratulations to all of our finalists and all of our new queens. You're amazing.